You know, Jody talked about disobedience this morning and the importance of obedience in the life of a Christian. And when we disobey the Lord, there are consequences.
Amen.
To disobeying the Lord. And we're encouraged to strive to enter in at the straight gate, to be obedient. You know, the Bible teaches us in the Old Testament, the prophet Samuel said, it is better to obey than to sacrifice.
Yeah.
And so the Lord puts a premium on obedience. And here we have in this book a man that disobeyed the Lord, and he suffered a great consequence because of it. And it's what sin, what befell Jonah is representative of what sin will do to you and where it will lead to. And we're going to read one verse of Scripture here. And you pray for us that God might minister to us here this morning. And we appreciate the song service and the fellowship of God's Spirit already in the Sunday school. And we pray that God might continue to bless here around about Mount Olive during the preaching hour as well. Now the verse of Scripture that we'll be looking at is Jonah 1 and verse 17. Verse 17. Now the Lord had prepared a great fish to swallow up Jonah, and Jonah was in the belly of the fish 3 days and three nights. Well, as we said, there are consequences to sin, and to me, I got to thinking about this and meditating on this when the Lord began to deal with me about this verse of Scripture and what is on my heart. You know, I got to thinking about that whale is kind of representative of where sin leads. You know it?
Yeah.
Of where sin leads. You know, the consequence of Jonah's sin was that he was swallowed up. And he was consumed.
Yeah.
And you know, that's what sin does. It's always hungry, isn't it?
Right.
Amen. Sin is always hungry. The lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, you know, it's a continual consuming. And that's the way that this fish was. It just swallowed up Jonah. And you know, the interesting thing about it was, is that fish swallowed up Jonah, every bit of him.
Right.
You know, and that's how big sin is today. Did you know that?
That's
right. That's how big sin is today. Sin is able to swallow us up completely.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. It's able to engulf us. And you know what else? When sin is so powerful and can swallow you up and consume you to such a degree until it entirely incapacitates you.
Right.
What do you mean by that, preacher? I mean that once sin gets a hold of you, and once sin swallows you up and consumes you, God bless your heart, there's nothing you can do about it. God bless your heart. You know, Jonah thought, well, I can flee from the presence of God. God would just have to get over it. God bless your heart. You know, how many people are living with that mentality today? God, you're just going to have to deal with what I want to do. Bless God, because I want to do it. Well, let me tell you one thing, my dear hearers. God bless your heart. There's a consequence to your disobedience unto God. And just like the Lord had prepared a great feast to swallow up Jonah, bless God this morning. I tell you, there's a place prepared for those that are disobedient and rebellious. My heart's prayer unto God this morning is that you would seek to serve God, seek to obey God, seek to live for God. God bless your heart. Because if you don't, sin will wrap you up and consume you and take away all your power. God bless your heart and your ability in this world. Praise God. It'll move you out of sight and out of mind. God bless your heart. I tell you this morning, when Jonah went into the belly of the whale, you know, nobody else knew what happened to him, did they? God bless your heart. I tell you this morning, you look around and you wonder what's happened to people. Bless God, I'll tell you, if sin has got a hold of them today, bless God, sin has swallowed them up, and you wonder where they went to and what happened to them. Bless God. But I tell you, God knows all of that.
Amen.
God knows all about it. Amen. Bless God. Amen. You have no course of action to change things. Amen. Jonah couldn't do anything in the belly of the whale other than one thing, which we'll get to here shortly. Amen. Bless God. But I tell you, he didn't have any resources. He didn't have any way, bless God, to influence that whale to spit him out. I tell you this morning, whether you want to believe it or not, sin is a powerful force in this world. It's a powerful force in this world. And it'll get you in its grip. It'll get you in its clutches. It'll get you and it'll consume you. And you won't be able to win, bless God, apart from Christ. I tell you, the only way to fight the battle this morning is through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and praying every day that he'll help you to walk the walk of faith. Praise be unto God, because I tell you, sin a life at the door.
That's right.
Amen. Praise God. Sin is just right around every corner. Did you know that?
Right
around every corner, sin is on every hand. Did you know that?
Amen.
Amen. Bless God, I tell you. Jonah went down into the belly of the whale. He was incapacitated. He had no course of action to change things. He was rendered, bless God, three things, and I want to look at those things. He was rendered helpless. Bless God, I tell you, the devil has a lot of power today, don't he?
That's right.
Amen. You know, people want to laugh and draw little pictures of the devil with his pitchfork and with his horns. Bless God, I tell you, that booger's sly today. I tell you, he'll change himself into an angel of light. Bless God. He'll deceive you. He'll lead you down the wrong path. Bless God. And I tell you, he's a powerful force in this world today. Bless God, don't underestimate him. And the only way to overcome him is through Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Praise be unto God. Jonah was rendered helpless. Amen. And within ourselves, amen, we don't have any power to fight the devil.
No.
Amen. Do you remember over there in the book of Acts, those men that said they were going to cast out the devil through the man that the man of God preached?
Yeah.
Through the name of Jesus Christ? Said, I adjure thee to come out of him through that man whom Paul preacheth. Bless God, Jesus Christ. Amen. But the spirit of the devil came on them, didn't it?
Right.
Amen. Blessed be unto God. I tell you, the only way to defeat the devil this morning is to be filled with the spirit and the power of God. Amen. As the disciples were there in the early church, we studied about in Sunday school this morning. Praise God. Why were they able to accomplish great things in the Lord? Because they were fully surrendered and committed to God.
Amen.
Amen. They were obedient unto God.
Right.
That's how you have more of the Spirit and the power of God, is through your obedience
right.
unto God. Jonah, bless his heart. Amen. He thought he could go on vacation when God called him to do something, didn't he?
Yeah.
Amen. Praise God. I tell you, a lot of times it sounds more comfortable to kick our feet up, don't it? Amen. Praise God to relax. But it's not any time for us to lay our cross down and to fall out of agreement with God. God bless your heart. It's not time for Christians to be on vacation. Bless God. I'm not talking about going out on a trip. I'm talking about laying God aside and living any way you want to do. Bless God. God told Jonah, said, go down to Nineveh, preach to those people. God bless your heart. And he turned around and he went the opposite
Amen.
Way.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. God tells you to do something. God leads you. You better follow God.
Amen.
Amen. You're going to wind up in a heap of trouble if you don't.
Yeah.
You certainly are. Amen. If you don't follow God. And that's what Jonah did. He was rendered helpless. He couldn't do anything about his situation. Amen. I've often thought about those 3 days and three nights in the belly of the whale, what it must have been like. Amen. Bless God. I can deal with the dark all right. I couldn't when I was a child, but I've learned to deal with it as I've gotten older. God bless your heart. But can you imagine 3 days and three nights of total darkness? Not knowing what was going to take place in your life. Amen. Not knowing what had happened. Amen. Not being able, bless God, to do anything about the situation. He was totally helpless in this regard. Amen. In being totally helpless, he was not only rendered helpless, but he was rendered hopeless, wasn't he?
Right.
Amen. Blessed be unto God. Let me tell you something this morning. When sin gets a hold of you, the only hope, bless God, that you have is in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. He's the only deliverer this morning.
Right.
Praise be unto God. He was rendered helpless and hopeless and happy. Let me tell you something. There wasn't any joy in that belly of the whale. Do you think so? You know, sometimes God has to stir us up, doesn't
he? Right.
Get our attention. We talked about this morning Ananias and Sapphira, the fear that fell on the entire church because of the disobedience of Ananias and Sapphira. Amen. Let me tell you something. Sometimes the church gets a little bit too comfortable, don't
they?
Get a little bit too lackadaisical and just kind of lay back and say, well, you know, things are just rocking along all right.
Yeah.
Amen. They get a little bit too comfortable. Let me tell you something. The Bible says our God is a consuming fire.
Right.
Amen. Praise be unto God. And I tell you, we're taught to fear and respect and honor God. And once you let your guard down and you begin to think you're all right with God and everything is rocking along real well with God, I tell you, here was Jonah. He thought God would accept the fact that Jonah said, I don't feel like going, God. Let me tell you something this morning. Praise God. Where God leads, He provides. God called him to a service. Bless God. And I tell you, where God leads you, He's going to take care of you.
Amen.
Amen. God didn't lead him to sin. God didn't lead him to sin. It wasn't God's will for him to wind up in the belly of a whale. It was God's will for him to go down and preach to the men of Nineveh. Amen. Praise be unto God. But he was rendered in the belly of the whale helpless, hopeless, and hapless. Why is that, preacher? Because there was no escape for him. Amen. Bless God, I tell you something else sin will do. You know, wherever that whale went, it took Jonah, didn't it?
That's right. That's right.
Y'all think about that now. Sin will take you where it wants you to go.
Right.
And you can't help it. You can't change the course of the direction of it. Once it swallows you and consumes you and renders you helpless, hopeless, and hapless, amen, until you turn back to God. Amen. There's hope in Christ Jesus now. Amen. But He's the only way.
Right.
He's the only way. He's the only deliverer. But up until that time, amen, where sin takes you, that's where you're going to wind up. Did you know it?
Amen.
Amen. Praise be unto God. Wherever that whale took him, let me tell you something. The wonderful thing about it was, is that God called him to go down there and preach to Nineveh. And after he repented and called on the name of God, and God delivered him out of the belly of the whale, where did the whale spit him up at? Where he needed to be. Amen. Praise be unto God. I tell you, God can work, bless God, whatever way you might find yourself, whatever condition you might find yourself, if you'll just turn back to God, God can deliver you. God can still use you and God can still bless you. Bless God. But my advice to you this morning is not to be disobedient and wind up in the belly of the whale to begin with.
Amen.
Amen. Not to wind up in the belly of the whale to begin with. Nobody could help Jonah whatsoever. Nobody could catch that whale and make that whale burp Jonah out, could they? Amen. It took God intervening. Let me tell you something. if you're delivered from sin, if you've been saved, if you've been washed in the blood, if you're right with God this morning, give glory to God. That's not man's work, that's God's work.
Amen.
Amen. As we studied this morning in Sunday school, amen, all of these great men of God, and you've got to admire them. You've got to admire them, and you've got to hold them in high regard and high esteem as far as the kingdom of God is concerned.
Yeah.
But every time they did something for God, they said, it's not me.
That's right.
It's not me. Amen. When Peter and John went into the gate, which was called Beautiful, and the man laid there asking alms, they said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ, rise up and walk. Praise God. And the man was healed. The lame man was healed. And when they all came rushing to Peter and John to give them glory, Peter said, ye men of Israel and Galilee, why look ye so earnestly on us? It's through our power we've made this man whole. It's through the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. You accomplish anything great this morning, you do anything, give glory to God.
Amen.
Amen. If you wind up in the belly of the whale, look at yourself. Amen. It's because you're not done as God has commanded. It's because you've been disobedient. Amen. Sin is hungry for you, and sin is hungry for me. It's never satisfied. I believe Proverbs 27:20 says that hail and destruction are never full. Are never full. Why is that, preacher? Bless God, I tell you, that hail was made for the devil and his angels. But bless God, I tell you, there's so many people today that want to deny God, want to rebel against God, want to push against God. And that's why this morning hail hath enlarged herself.
Right.
It's because so many have rebelled against God. It's not God's will that any should perish. As we said, it wasn't God's will for Jonah to wind up in the belly of the whale. But it was through his own disobedience that he wound up in the belly of the whale. Amen. Look with me to chapter 2. That was the last verse in chapter 1. Well, what do you do when sin consumes you, preacher? What do you do when sin incapacitates you and you no longer can do anything about it? Sin has got a hold of you. I tell you, the only thing you can do is to do as Jonah did. Turn to God.
Yeah. Right.
Turn to God. As long as you got breath in your body and can pray and look up, you need to call upon the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Praise be unto God. Chapter 2, verse 2. He talks about being in the belly of the whale, and he said, I cried by reason of my affliction. Let me tell you something. Sin, you know, might be satisfying for a season, but it brings great torment. Did you know that?
Right.
The Bible said that Moses chose to suffer with the children of God, to suffer with God, than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. Amen. You might think that you know you're really living it up and things are going well for you and you're having a good time. Amen. You're having a great time. Amen. Let me tell you something this morning. There's great affliction that awaits you. There's great torment that awaits you. Amen. Why is that, preacher? Because if you fail to call upon the name of God, if you fail to look toward God and seek Him with all of your heart, soul, mind, and strength, if you continue on in that sin, it's going to lead to death, hell, and the grave.
Right. Amen.
Amen. Praise be unto God. There's affliction in sin. People might think that you know it's all right. Bless God, but I tell you, it's an affliction to your soul and to your life. He said, I cried by the reason of mine affliction unto the Lord. Amen. And the wonderful thing was He heard me, and He called it the belly of hell, which sin ultimately leads to hell, doesn't it?
Right.
Amen. If you don't do anything about it, that's where you go. Verse 4, look down there to verse 4 in chapter 2. This is all Jonah's prayer here in chapter 2. He said, "Then I said, I am cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again toward thy holy temple." Amen. Let me tell you something. Sin separates you from God.
Amen.
Amen. You can't have fellowship with God and have fellowship with the world and sin. Amen. Praise God. We had a wonderful Sunday school lesson this morning talking about sin will always find you out.
Right.
It'll find you out. It'll discover you and it'll expose the truth, won't it?
Right.
Amen. Praise God. Sin will find you out. Amen. Let me tell you something. God already knows where you are, what you think, what you do, what you believe. God knows all of these things. Bless God. I tell you, you need to come repenting and confessing unto Him. Amen. Because God already knows about it. God knows your sin. And what does sin do? Verse 4, he said here in verse 4 of chapter 2, "I am cast out of thy sight." You can't have any fellowship with God because God's not going to have anything to do with it.
Right.
Amen. How are you able to make that statement, preacher, so emphatically? The Bible says your sins have separated between you and God.
Right.
I mean, how much more explicit can you get? If you're here and you don't feel the presence and the peace of God, amen. If you're here and you don't feel, bless God, the closeness of God and the nearness of God and the ministering of the Holy Spirit of God, there's something in your life you need to talk to God about.
Amen.
You need to bring it before God. You need to confess it and lay it on the altar so that God can deal with it. See, Jonah, he knew that he had sinned. Bless God, he was at the point of suicide.
Yeah.
And how often are we hearing about that today? People just throwing in the towel. I've had all I can stand, and I'm going to roll the dice, and I'm going to kill myself and see what God thinks about it. That's what Jonah did. There was a great storm that came up, and all those mariners out there in that boat with Jonah,
yeah,
they began to cast the wares from the boat, and they began to call upon their gods, and Jonah was down there asleep.
Yeah.
That's just like somebody that's out of fellowship with God.
Yeah.
Out of fellowship, not where they need to be with God. And they went down there and they said, "Arise, O sleeper, and call upon thy God." And Jonah knew what the problem was right off the bat. He said, I'm the reason. Amen. Bless God, you have trouble in the church. You have trouble with fellowship. You have trouble among the people of God. Bless God, there's sin in the camp.
Amen.
There's sin in the camp. Amen. And there was sin on that boat. Amen. Jonah told the men, said, "Just lift me up and cast me out into the sea."
Yeah.
Amen. He just said, "Away with me, O God," and just said, "Throw me out." And the men didn't want to do that. You read it. They didn't want to do that. They rowed hard. They tried to overcome the storm. But they were left with no choice, and they threw Jonah overboard. But God prepared a great fish to swallow him up.
Yeah.
Amen. Because of his disobedience, that which was his sin was also his deliverer to bring him the second chance that he needed to repent and call on the name of God. Let me tell you something. If God gives you a second chance, you better take advantage of it.
Amen.
Amen. You know, the Bible says, "My spirit shall not always strive with man." He was cast out of the presence of God. He found himself in the belly of the whale. But Jonah was a man that knew what he had seen and come short. And he called on the name of God. And God heard him out of the belly of the whale.
Amen.
That should be good news for every one of us here this morning.
That's right.
That when we sin and come short of the glory of God, where we're not where we need to be, we'll cry to God. God, in His great mercy, can hear our prayer. Amen. Sin is strong. Sin is powerful. Sin will take you where you don't want to go. But God knows all about it. He's able to deliver. Amen. He said in verse 6 of chapter 2, I went down to the bottoms of the mountains. The earth with her bars was about me forever. Yet hast thou brought up my life from corruption, O Lord my God. Sin brings about corruption, doesn't it?
Right.
Amen. What are you talking about, preacher? Jonah was as good as dead in the belly of the whale. He was as good as dead. Amen. He had been forgotten about. Nobody knew where he was. Now the mariners, all they knew is they threw him overboard and assumed he had died. Amen. But bless God, there was a great whale that come swimming along and opened up his mouth, and Jonah went inside. Amen. And Jonah went inside that whale, and it was just as if he had went to the bottoms of the earth into hell itself, and the bars were enclosed about him. I've already mentioned the darkness. Amen. The darkness that was there, the seaweed that was there, the water that was there, the fighting to keep from drowning that was taking place there. Amen. A whale takes in a lot of water, brother.
Yeah, that's right.
Y'all ever seen any footage of a whale shooting water out of them? How many gallons come out of them? Amen. They take a lot of water in. Amen. Can you imagine? Here's Jonah in the belly of the whale trying to stay alive and pray at the same time. Amen. Bless God. I tell you, God knew where he was and what he needed. Amen. He was just as if he had corrupted and went to hell, but God delivered him from his sin because he had an opportunity to repent and to call on the name of the Lord, and he took advantage of it.
Amen.
Amen. It says it was in corruption and destruction here in verse 6. Also two times in verses 3 and 5, it said he was compassed about by these things. He was totally consumed by these things. He was as good as dead. Amen. One thing that was needed in this situation, and one thing that is needed more today than anything else, is for people to lay aside every weight and the sin which doth so easily beset us, and look unto Jesus and cry out to God and pour our hearts and our souls out to him. Amen. Bless God. I tell you, let me tell you something. You know, life's hard. Life is hard. And you know what? It's getting more hard every day, isn't it? Amen. Life is getting more difficult every day. And if the good Lord allows you to live, the longer you live, the harder life's going to be. Do you know that?
Yeah.
Amen. The more difficult it's going to be. And that cross gets so heavy, gets so heavy, gets so heavy. Amen. Bless God. But I tell you this morning, I'd rather take that cross all the way and be welcomed into the kingdom of God than to throw it aside and enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season and die and go to heaven.
Amen.
Amen. Blessed be unto God. I tell you, once Jesus Christ comes into your heart, in your life, amen, there's nothing in this world that compares with him. You fall in love with him. He first loved us, and that's why we loved him so much. While I was lost, while I was dead in sins and trespasses, God sent forth his Son into the world to die for my sins. Amen. And I was saved. I heard the gospel message, and I received Jesus Christ into my heart and my life. Amen. Verse 7 says of chapter 2. Listen, this is great advice here, because all of us have to contend with sin. When my soul fainted within me, I remembered the Lord. I remembered the Lord. How many people today need to remember God?
Yeah.
You know what the Bible says? Remember from whence thou art fallen.
Right.
And repent and do the first works. Why does the Bible say to do that in the book of Revelation? Let me tell you something. When you first become a Christian, when you first become a child of God, you're on fire for God, aren't you?
That's right.
Amen. Those first works are amazing. Because you just can't do enough for God.
Right.
You can't love God enough. You can't be close enough to God. Amen. You're always faithful and present to do the work of God. Let me tell you something. Over time, we begin to slip back, don't we?
Yeah.
Amen. And you know, I believe with all of my heart, you can disagree with this if you want to, but I believe, and I'm talking about everyone, me included, all of us to a certain degree backslide.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about we just fall all the way back into sin. I'm not talking about that. I'm not talking about that we, you know, leave God, leave the church, and leave doing the things of God. I think that we kind of lose a little bit of that enthusiasm and fire.
Amen.
We lose a little bit of that enthusiasm and fire that we once had for Christ Jesus.
Yeah.
So in a way, all of us kind of slip and slide away from that. But that's, you know, the thing about it is always seek to stay in fellowship with God and remember how those first works were so prevalent in your heart and your life and how they meant so much to you. Praise be unto God, and repent and seek to draw nigh unto God.
Amen.
You know what the Bible says? Draw nigh unto God and He'll draw nigh unto you.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've ever been told this. I've been told this before. Preacher, I want to be closer to God. Well, the Bible says to draw nigh unto God and He'll draw nigh unto you.
Right.
Amen. If you'll seek the Lord God with all of your heart, soul, mind, and strength, if you'll love Him with all of your heart, soul, mind, and strength, if you'll read and study to show thyself approved unto God, if you'll commit your way unto the Lord, if you'll obey Him, if you'll follow Him, take up thy cross daily and follow Him. Let me tell you something. God will draw nigh to you. God will love you. God will keep you. God will guide and direct you into the ways of truth and righteousness. It's the Bible, folks. I mean, it's not that hard. Let me tell you something. God has not asked any more out of any of us than what we're capable of.
That's right.
Amen. God is not an unreasonable God. We should just seek. You know, Paul put it this way, I believe it's Romans chapter 12. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice unto God, which is just a reasonable service.
That's right. Amen.
Instead of giving your body over to the lust of the flesh, to work the works of sin, render your body over unto God, amen, which is just your reasonable service, and God will bless you. God will love you, and God will continue with you. Amen. Bless God. Lord had prepared a great fish to swallow up Jonah. That great fish came along, and as Jonah went down into the depths, the great fish swallowed him up. Amen. And the interesting and the most important thing about it is when Jonah found himself in the belly of the whale, in the midst of sin and his disobedience, and being out of fellowship and out of the will of God because God had cast him from his sight, he remembered the Lord. He remembered the mercies of God, and he prayed to Him. Amen. In verse 9, we'll finish up there of chapter 2. I will sacrifice unto thee with the voice of thanksgiving. I will pay that I have vowed. Salvation is of the Lord.
Yeah, amen.
He right there, he got it right with God, didn't he?
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. You know when you get it right with God, don't you, brother?
That's right.
Amen. You know when you get it right with God. And I tell you, Jonah right here, he got it right with God. Why is that? Because he said, God, I will pay that I vowed. Apparently, Jonah had vowed before in the past that God, whatever you tell me to do, I'll do. And how many of us here this morning have said the same thing?
Yeah.
We've said the same thing. God, whatever you tell me to do, I'll do.
Amen.
But then God asks us to do something, and we're like Jonah. We want to say, well, I want to go my own way. Amen. Let me tell you something. It don't work like that, folks. It don't work like that, folks. He sacrificed unto God with a voice of thanksgiving because he knew that he had had a breakthrough prayer, that God had heard and answered his prayer. And he recognized God, remembered him, recognized him, reconciled with him, and repented unto him. Amen. Praise be unto God. And he recommitted unto him here in this verse of Scripture. Amen. He said, I'll pay that God back.